Good morning. Welcome to my watch disassembly stream. The purpose of this video is to try disassembling a watch for the first time. I've done plenty of watching other people assemble watches and learned a bit about how that happens. But I've never done it myself, and I have a bunch of scrap movements around and a couple of new working movements as well. As in the case, this is an ETA 2836, if I remember correctly. But I'm not brave enough to try that one first, so I'll put that onto one side. The choice comes down to two sets of old scrap movements I've got. This one is a fairly modern automatic movement. That's not ideal because automatic makes it more complicated. But I don't have a similar condition manual wind one. This is a very old pocket watch movement, but this is very unfamiliar in construction. There aren't sort of like this standard location of the barrel. The winding is on the side there. So I think that's too adventurous for a first attempt. So I'm going to go with the automatic movement. Take it apart as far as I can. And then hopefully eventually, once I completely take it apart, I'm going to try putting it back together again. And who knows, it may even work. It doesn't work at the moment, so I can't make it that much worse. Before we do that, I'm just going to turn the chat view on so I can actually see it. Better. Nobody here yet. In case it's not obvious, face is on really, really bad condition on this watch, so I'm not going to worry too much about preserving that condition. It's also currently missing a hand. Balance wheel moves. The automatic wind back counterweight moves. And most of the movement looks as though it's retrievable, if not in perfect condition. So I'm going to start by removing the hand. If I cared about this face, I would have some protection in place, either some paper or some plastic, but I don't. Ideally, at this point, I would like to try and work out what I need to do to remove the face entirely. It looks like there's some kind of catch just there, which may be holding the face on. There's something similar there underneath the bridge. See if I can get the counterweight off first. There's what sounded like a release of power when I did that, which makes me wonder if I just shot the spring. The part there does very much look as though it should be movable. There we go. And there looks like there's a pin attached to the face just there. This one is out as well. the face is off. So I don't know if you can see that, but there is a lot of corrosion on the surface underneath, a lot of green. It looks like copper or brass corrosion. Which is fine. Going to put these catches back because they look quite delicate. They look like they actually should be done with a special tool. Now that the calendar complication and other things are exposed, I'm going to switch to a proper movement holder rather than relying on the soft pad. Thank you, Ryan. Welcome to the stream. Sorry about the audio volume. I will turn it up a bit. That should be really quite a lot louder. Let me know if that's any better. I put a bunch of effort before the stream to working out a way to improve the sound quality, but it didn't work. So I had to go back to my old config, and it looks like I didn't manage to get the volumes right. I need to get a different loop piece. The light in this one has run out of battery. Back in a moment. This one's a bit better. So it looks as though this ring towards the center this ring just here, which is holding two wheels which were engaged with the counterbalance for the automatic winding, it's held at least by that blue screw there. So I'm going to try removing that screw. So it's turned freely and appears to be loose, but I can't actually get a hold of it with the tweezers. That side of the bridge is free though, and it lifts independently of that screw there. So I think it's just being held by that silver screw there now. It's too big. That screw has risen up in a much more expected way. So I think now this plate should just lift. And there we go, wheels included. So I'm now going to try and remind myself exactly where that did go. It went there. More signs of corrosion, unfortunately. So this may end up being only a disassembly exercise rather than an easy repair. It looks as though the part I've removed already was entirely to do with the automatic winding mechanism. And it looks as though the hairspring is broken. Or not. No, I think it is still intact. So my next step is going to be attempting to work out how the click works, in the hope that I can find a way to release the click and get the any remaining power out of the mainspring before I go any further. Feels as though the winder won't wind anymore. Which suggests the mainspring, or the mainspring barrel at least, is wound to its limit, which may mean that the mainspring itself is broken. I cannot see any sign of the click. I don't know what I'm exactly looking for, but I've seen videos of clicks in other watches, and I can't see anything that looks like what I'm looking for. I'm struggling to put the watch at an angle where I can be reasonably certain the camera can see it. So the stem has a wheel mounted vertically here, which meshes with this wheel here, which transfers power to this wheel here, which is mounted coaxially with the barrel, which is directly underneath it. So I think this is connected to the mainspring arbor inside the barrel. Everything appears to be locked solid at the moment, which might be because this wind chain is wound up against its stop that prevents it from being overwound. And I'm going to assume that the mainspring is broken. There's no way to release it. There's no power there to be released. So I'm going to try removing these two wheels and see what happens. And if I get an explosive release of power, I will know I got that wrong. And today I'm learning the value of a good set of watchmaker screwdrivers, which incidentally I don't own. I can't, this li wheel won't lift out, and I can't tell whether that's because it's under a lot of tension or just because everything is seized up. The hole in the center of the wheel is square, and you can see where it's engaged with the mainspring arbor. When I try and lift that, it almost feels as though the mainspring arbor is straining against it, which makes me feel like I'm just going to release the tension spring, which is exactly what I want. If the spring is intact, I don't want, exactly don't want to do that. I am going to see if I can find any descriptions online on how to find and release the click on an automatic movement before I proceed. Thank you. I should probably watch the Watch Repair channel to find how to do this. If anybody hasn't watched this channel, it's awesome and absolutely the best way to learn how to repair and maintain watches. Let's have another look. So at the bottom edge of this wheel just here, there is a pin stuck up between the teeth. Which would explain why I can't move it. I'm going to get some more magnifiers. So it is a lot easier to see what's going on with a magnifier. But I haven't managed to move anything. So there's a round pin on what looks like a lever that's underneath this wheel. The round pin is securely lodged in the teeth of this wheel, so preventing it from turning. But nothing I do appears to be able to persuade the lever to budge at all. It's completely unclear whether it's related to the click or whether it's to do with preventing overwinding. The disadvantage of trying to disassemble an automatic is that I don't understand yet most of the complexities involved in how automatic watches manage too much activity and how they prevent overwinding. It doesn't look as though it's going to be safe to remove any other part of the watch in the meantime. This bridge here holds most of the gear train in place, all of which will be under tension from the mainspring if there is any tension in the mainspring. I can see the escapement there. I think I am pretty much stuck. I need to go away and read up on how to release the power from automatic movements. And it's not going to be a fun or interesting stream to watch me do that. Not that it has been much fun or interest so far. That's disappointing, but honestly, the fact that I've managed to get this far without obviously breaking anything, finding all the right bits so far, I'm pretty happy with that. Judging by the chat, there hasn't been that many people here. I have no idea if that's because they found it profoundly boring or because I didn't advertise this well enough. But if you're interested in seeing another stream like this, let me know. I'll probably run one anyway because it's a convenient way to make sure it gets recorded and put somewhere where I can permanently access it. And I assume somebody might, in some sense, learn from watching a bumbling amateur try and disassemble a watch with no real solid information as to how. Sorry about the audio problems at the start, and thanks to everybody who did come and watch. And I'll see you again soon when I do another stream. The next live stream is almost certainly going to be back on the restoring the watchmaker's lathe. And I'll leave assembling, disassembling the watch until I know what I'm doing a bit more. Bye for now.